The transition from coal power to renewables, a popular discussion at the recently concluded COP29 conference. For the Philippines, while much has yet to be done, church leaders are doing their part by harnessing the power of the sun. Ani Perez has that story.
At this year's Conference of Parties in Baku, Azerbaijan, several demonstrations focused on the transition from coal-fired plants to renewable energy. Groups claim fossil fuels harm the environment, health, and even marine life. The Center for Energy, Ecology, and Development reports there is massive potential in the Southeast Asian region, mostly for wind and solar energy. Only 33.8 gigawatts is added to the current power supply, a far cry from the plan of 397.8 gigawatts.
What kind of climate anomaly has to happen for us to finally abandon fossil fuels and to push for genuine solutions in the form of renewable energy?
Although there are already expansions for renewable energy in some provinces, it is not enough. The Philippines recently ranked 7 in the Climate Change Performance Index with low scores for the transition to clean energy.
Even though the coal has been reduced and is reducing, the energy source that is being used to replace it is sadly natural gas, even though it is lower emission, as we all know from a coal, but natural gas is still heavily extractive.
A more concrete solution is offered by the church. By targeting 10 million solar panels across parishes and partner organizations, the pilot area, Diocese of Maasin.
And so we're appealing, no? Of course, using the network of the church to make people all involved. This is something that is important as an approach because it is not just by few people, but really involving more people. So it's empowering, it's making people participate and take responsibility for our future, for our climate, for our environment.
Bishop Alminaza monitors his own solar panels with his mobile phone. Other parishes are also doing the same. Their next move is to involve the congregation to also use solar energy. Lay ministers in the church are also active in advocating for climate justice.
The goal of the project is to enhance the adaptive capacities of our cities in the Philippines to the impacts of climate change.
Maps, reports, and other data are created for LGUs and other key stakeholders. 10 million solar panels might not be enough to meet the energy requirement of the Philippines to transition to renewable energy, but the church sends a strong message that they are one in the cause for climate adaptation, mitigation, and climate justice. Ani Perez, ABS-CBN News, Baku, Azerbaijan.
The chair of a UN negotiating committee is confident countries will be able to pave the way for an international treaty to curb plastic pollution. UNINC Chair Luis Valles Valdivieso said this as South Korea hosts a fifth UNINC 5 meeting this week. Talks in Ottawa in April ended without a plan to cap plastic pollution. Ongoing negotiations in Busan will focus on chemicals of concern and other measures after petrochemical producing nations like Saudi Arabia and China strongly opposed efforts to target plastic pollution.
I'm confident that we will reach an agreement here in Busan for the 1st of December. And I'm confident that text that we will agree with the member states here in Busan will give us the path to combat and to end plastic pollution with credible rules.
Social security institutions in Southeast Asia said they are open for more collaboration as delegates gather in Manila. Let's get more details from our correspondent, Jackie Pascual. Jackie?
Hi, Ron. Various social security institutions in Southeast Asia collectively manage $1.3 trillion U.S. dollars in assets, and they are considering collaborating more with each other, possibly even co-investing in projects in the region. Delegates gathered here in Manila for the 41st ASEAN Social Security Association meetings which will start today and will end on November 27. Officials from different organizations hope for a deeper partnership as they navigate the future of Social Security. ASA Chairperson Ahmad Zulkarnain-On, who is also the Chief Executive Officer of Malaysia's Employees Provident Fund, said they will discuss ways how they will work with each other and invest in projects that will benefit the region as a whole. Meanwhile, Government Service Insurance System President and General Manager Jose Arnulfo Viloso, who is the ASA Vice Chairman, said that they will know the risk appetite of each member and a future collaboration is also possible. He added that the collective $1.3 trillion in assets is huge and can create a big economic impact in the region. These investments, they said, can spur regional development. They also said that Viloso also said that they may also check on investment opportunities in sectors or areas that they may not be too familiar with, and they hope to learn more from this forum. The Philippine members of ASA are GSIS, SSS, PhilHealth, Pag-ibig Fund, Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office, and the Employees Compensation Commission. And that's later, Ron. Back to you,
Jackie Pascual, with that story. Thanks, Jackie.